In this problem, we're given the mass of an object in grams, and we're given the speed of the object in meters per second, and both of these come with uncertainty. And we're trying to compute the momentum of the object, which is the mass times the speed. We want to get that in kilogram meters per second with the uncertainty computed using a propagation of errors formula. So the first order of business here is to just get the mass in the right units. It's given in grams, and I want it in kilograms. So I shift the decimal point 3 spaces to the left. So this is 0.252 plus or minus 0.001 kilograms. So we can immediately find P, the momentum of this thing. That's just mass times velocity in the correct units, and this gives me 2.5704, just keeping some extra precision for the moment, kilogram meters per second. But the main part of this problem is computing the uncertainty in P correctly. And because P is a product of two measured quantities, we use the product formula for propagation of error, and I'll post a link to where this was first introduced real quick. So we have delta P over P is equal to the square root of delta M over M, the relative uncertainty in the mass squared. And then in our second term, we have the relative uncertainty in the speed squared. Plug the numbers into that, smash it into a calculator, and we get 0.04918. And there are no units on that. It's basically telling us there's a 5% uncertainty in the momentum. Then to get delta P itself, we have to move this P over to the other side of the equation. So delta P is going to be P times 0.04918. But our momentum P was 2.5704. So we'll put that in, 2.5704 times 0.04918. And this gives me 0.126. And this has units of momentum, so kilogram meters per second. So there's our proper uncertainty. Now there's a rounding convention that I like to use where we round uncertainties to one significant digit. So this would round down to 0.1. So approximately equal to 0.1. And then we round the actual quantity to the same decimal place. So to the tenths place, and that's going to round up because there's a 7 in the hundredths place. And we arrive at P plus or minus delta P. That's a momentum of 2.6 plus or minus 0.1. kilogram meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.